Okay, so hello guys. So yesterday it was 25th December. So I hope you all got a nice Christmas time. You got to spend a nice Christmas time actually. Okay, so today, first I have to check my camera angle, okay? Because I am using a Gareeb ka setup. Okay, let's see the camera angle, fix it properly. I guess it's okay. Let's continue. Yesterday it was 25th December and I hope you all had a nice time, okay? So, Merry Christmas. Belated Christmas, I know. But I hope you are going to have a very nice and greeting and warm, cheery new year. Please enjoy it because you don't get so much time to enjoy, do we? Okay. So, starting off with nucleic acid and nucleotides. Actually, this is the repetition of my previous video. What I am going to deal in this video particularly is the components of nucleotides. So, these components of nucleotides are simply the sugar fuckers. Now, these sugar fuckers can be of two types. Sugar fuckers can be of two types. Will my video be banned because I use that word? I don't think so. Two types, the envelope form, the endoform, and the twisted, the exoform. Now, we have endoplane right in the upwards and the exoplane right in the downwards. What I'm going to talk is about, this is the endoplane. Whatever present in this side is the endoplane and whatever present down below is the exoplane. Now, what are sugar fuckers basically? These sugar fuckers are actually pentose fuckers present in nucleotides and are non-planar in nature. So this non-planarity is known as the puckering. Although we have two faces of planarity, so it's not only one type of planarity, it's a two type planarity. So it has got two faces, like you have when you lie to your mom about stealing from her purse and then you blame it on your servant. Okay, just leave it. Now, we have got two faces, envelope and twisted. The envelope being the endoform and the twisted being the exoform. Now, this, first we'll talk about the envelope form. This envelope form has got four carbons that are nearly coplanar while the fifth away from them, or the plane actually. So, these four carbons that are coplanar in nature while the fifth is away from the plane is what defines the envelope form. That means that four of the carbons like 1 prime, 2 prime, 3 prime, 4 prime, they are quite in the plane. They are quite in the plane while the fifth carbon is away from the plane. It's in the endo side actually. Okay. Now, this fifth one is away. Why the hell? Because you were away from your ex-girlfriend when she tried to cheat on you. Or did you cheat on her? Answer me. Leave it. It's an educational video. Okay. Now, this is the thing which you have to remember. So, this C5 actually is like your ex-girlfriend leaving you. I don't care. Now, let's come to the next thing. That is a twisted form. This twisted form has three atoms. So, this is the twisted form I have drawn over here. It has got three atoms which are coplanar in nature while the other two lie away on the opposite sides. So the other two actually lie away on the opposite side, like this and this. So 5 prime, 4 prime, 1 prime, they are in the same plane where this 3 prime and 2 prime are away. Okay. Over here we have 4 prime, 2 prime, 1 prime. These are all in a same plane actually. So we are talking, suppose we take this example actually, it's very better. 4 prime, 3 prime and 4 prime, 2 prime, 1 prime. These are actually same. In same plane, okay. So this is the envelope form and this is the exoform or the twisted form. The difference lies that where the carbon is present, whether it is in this plane or in the down plane. If it is in the upward plane, then this endo in nature. This is, for example, the 3 prime is over in the endo plane, so it's C3 prime endo. Here, the C3 prime is also in the endo plane, so it's C3 prime endo. But The C2 prime over here is also in the exophase. So C3 prime endo plus C2 prime and C3 prime endo and C2 prime exo. This is it. And in this case, as we have found, it's only C2 prime endo. Okay, it's only C2 prime endo. Although I have drawn the C3 prime a bit in the downward point, that's my fault, because it shouldn't be this much downwards. It's my fault, definitely. Now we have the twisted form, the C2 prime endo and C3 prime exo. C2 prime endo because it's an endophase, and C3 prime exo because it's in the exophase. Actually, this diagram, it is not that much downwards. It should be somewhere like here, kind of in the same plane, and then it from here it goes to 2 prime. But obviously, I am very bad at diagrams, so I messed it up. Now, coming to the next point, the nucleosides. Now, what are nucleosides? The sugar and nitrogenous base, when they join together, they form the nucleoside. So, this sugar actually, when they join, like this sugar is actually in this many conformations, they actually join with the nucleus, the bases over here. These are bases. Adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine, uracil, it can be anything. But when it is joining with that, it is forming the nucleosides. The nucleosides are connected actually. This connection over here, this green colored H over here, and the bond showing towards the N of the nitrogenous base is actually known as the beta N glycosidic bond. It's a N glycosidic bond. It's a sugar attached to a nitrogenous base, and that's formed the nucleosides in our body. It is required in our DNA. Okay, so this can also have conformations now. So this video is actually about the conformations. I think you have got it by now. I'm dealing with the conformations over here. So it can have two conformations. One is syn conformation, one is anti-conformation. Okay, the syn is not the syn when you do, when you are doing any wrong or bad stuffs. I am talking about the different syn and not about Johnny syns. Okay, I am talking about the syn conformation where this nitrogenous bases are exactly situated over the sugar or the ribose sugar. I am talking about this nitrogenous base. See, this nitrogenous base is actually situated just over the oxygen atom of the ribose sugar. My board is not that big, otherwise I could have enlarged it a lot, but this is the thing. So this actually creates something known as repulsion, which you do regularly. How, I don't know. This is the thing. So this is what happens. And also we have got antipurine. Antipurine is like the opposite of synpurine. The nitrogenous base is actually arranged in such a way that this oxygen atom is not creating any kind of disturbance or hindrances with the this N over here of the amino base. Okay, so I have, for example, if I have drawn here, adenine is the amino base actually. So this is what happens in anti and syn conformations. Okay, so this is a simple concept, nothing much to learn from here. Just have to remember that whenever there are two heavy groups like oxygen and nitrogen, or oxygen and oxygen, or sometimes when methyl and methyl group placed very near in the structural conformations of any chemical compounds, it actually creates something known as repulsion, and that repulsion is very much dangerous, and it can cause stability increase or decrease for that molecule. If that highly weighty group is placed in such a way that it is not creating any kind of hindrance, that molecule should be stable. That molecule becomes stable. But whenever it creates any kind of hindrances, in that case the molecule is not stable. Okay, and the molecule is not stable, that means that that molecule is unstable, and unstable means like you guys are doing nothing. I'm just joking. Okay, I hope it doesn't affect my subscribers though. Okay, so enough with the joking and shit. Now talking about the nucleotides. Now these nucleotides are nothing but the phosphate esters. We have to remember about something known as the phosphate esters. The esters bond you have studied in organic chemistry. It's very much simple like that. Okay, just trying to see my camera angle if it is proper or not every time. It's okay with my moderate setup. Yeah, because my camera usually tilts down and doesn't record whole of my board. That's an issue. Now coming to nucleotides, we have phosphoric acid esters. So These are nothing. These are amino base I am talking about, along with the ribose sugar. And the fifth carbon of this ribose sugar, I am talking about this carbon, is attached via ester bond to phosphates. Now these phosphates are also ester bonded among themselves to form the triphosphates. Okay, these three phosphates are attached, 1, 2, and 3. Actually they are counted from this side, so it's alpha, beta and gamma, and these are the three phosphates or triphosphates. So these are nucleotide. Phosphoric acid esters are present in nucleotide. These are phosphoric acid esters. Okay, now this you have to learn. Now this is the nucleotide thing. This is present in DNA and it's also responsible for the this is also responsible for many kind of other activities in our body apart from being in the DNA, okay, which will come later. Now in my board I have written that anti-purine conformation, okay, I have talking about this is an anti-conformation. Why anti-conformation? Because this nitrogen over here is not placed directly over this oxygen over here in the ribose sugar. That's why it's an anti-conformation. So any anti-purine conformation, when it is held hand to hand with ribose sugar like this one, plus the ribose sugar can be enveloped, endo or exo, anything it can, plus phosphoric acid esters, this will give rise to the nucleotides. Now these nucleotides actually serve many functions which I am going to discuss now. They can be the component of ATP, GTP, CTP, TTP. These are all required for anabolism or catabolism in our body. Different kind of mechanisms require different kinds of energy compounds. It can be ATP, GTP, CTP, TTP, anything it can happen. Also in case of DNA replication, also in many different other cases of replication, other some biological reactions and everything, we need this. And also in different enzymes, these enzymes also have some pockets of ATP binding sites. But the ATP binds and makes the enzyme active, it can happen. This marker spell is making me nauseous. Okay, now next we have the NAD plus, NADP plus, these are all cofactors. So this NAD plus, NADP plus, FAD, coenzyme, this nicotinamide adenine 9 nucleotide, okay, this same thing, and FAD is flavin adenine dinucleotide, something like that, I forgot that obviously. So this FAD and coenzyme A, coenzyme is actually very important for lipid biosynthesis and also for catabolism, okay. So it's required over there. So these are all the things which are actually present in our body, and they need this ATP, GTP, CTP to work because they associate with them and then they function. Also we have CGMP and CAMP. So CGMP is actually cyclic guanidine monophosphate. The CGMP and CAMP are very important for our body because we need this in our body, and this is very important for many reactions as well as many physical things in our body, many physical processes happening in our body. Now, I will like to conclude this video by saying that thank you for making me reach 30 subscribers till now. And in next video, I will be talking about cell cycle, the checkpoints of cell cycle, as we have mentioned over here. So, all I need is support, okay. And I will need like, share, comment and subscribe my video. And thus, this is how I conclude my video, and thus I will end it.